Friends, welcome to Ashleo's Beagles. Today we would like to talk about how to stop puppies from biting. A lot of friends were asking for a very long time, you know, how to stop puppies from biting, because whenever they take the puppy home, they always face this problem. So we thought we'll make a short video on how to stop puppies biting. This is not a commercial video which we'll upload to YouTube for a certain commercial motive. This is only for information purpose, so it may not be very good quality or whatsoever that you normally look forward to. This is, we request you to please consider this purely as a information video. And I hope you will like the content. If there is anything that you would like to let us know, you can write back to us or ring us back or WhatsApp us. Friends, let's go forward to the video. Here we have Tia. Tia is my own breeding puppy. Father is Dex and mother is Gia. So we are going to teach her to stop biting today. And Ashleo is also going to help me. People face when they bring in a puppy and when they don't know how to bring up a puppy, is the puppy biting. When you play with them, when you pet them and they start to bite you, it's very unpleasant situation. So many people have been asking, you know, how to stop puppy biting. It's very simple. Today Ashleo is going to show us, you know, how to stop puppy from biting. A very simple way that you can do that. It's most importantly, you must, whenever the puppy, not only biting, whenever the puppy does anything that you don't want or anything that do not make you feel good, which is not the house rule, and you must tell the puppy then and there immediately, not afterwards, not by beating the puppy, not by harassing the puppy. You can tell the puppy very sternly like this: no, Tia, no. So what happens is, when you say no to the puppy is, when the snap happens, it is snapped out of what it is doing. If it is biting or if it is doing something which is a mischief, which is something that you don't like, the puppy will be snapped out of the particular act. So once you snap the puppy out of the act, then you tell the puppy no. It's like really loud, and you know, it's like you don't like it. Similarly, when the puppy does something really nice, cute, if you like what it does and it does what it's supposed to do, then you should say, yes, good girl, good girl. So you appreciate, and also you stop them from doing what is not right. And you should say no. So you connect them with wrong things and no. You connect them with right things, yes, followed by a good girl appreciation. So the puppy understands very, very quickly. They are very clever. They understand very quickly, and you will have a very good puppy at home. So.
No. 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 No.
Good. Very good. No. No.
Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. No. 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 Good girl. Good girl.
You can do it in two different ways. One, you can say no, and you can say yes, and you can also give a treat, a small piece of cheese or a small piece of ham, turkey, whatever, chicken or anything that is available, a small tiny piece as a treat when they do good things. So they connect the good things with the treat, so they always want to do good thing. The treat always will not be available in your hand, so you must always train them to connect with a word. Say yes or no, good, any word for that matter. The puppy is going to always lifelong connect a particular act with that particular word. So if they do something wrong, something not good, if you say no, then the no is what is the pup, according to the puppy, is something that you should not do. So they will connect with that. So you should always consistent, because if you say, okay, for example, if you want the puppy to come onto a sofa because you are in a good mood, so the puppy knows that sofa is the place where he can come or she can come anytime. But then you say, you pet the puppy, you say good and everything to the puppy when you are in a good mood. But when you are in a bad mood, you tell the puppy to get out and you say no, the puppy is confused. Puppy will not know whether it is a yes or it is no. So you should be consistent in what you're doing. You should always remain consistent. If there is a yes, it is yes. Always yes. If there is a no, there is a no. Always there is a no. So this is what I think is a simple way of training a puppy how not to bite. Not only biting, anything that which is not right to do, or which you don't like, or which is a house rule. So basically you should start training the puppy from the day one on your house rules, and telling the puppy yes or no from the day one will easily, quickly let the puppy learn the house rules, and you will have a wonderful puppy at home. So thank you very much, viewers. Thanks for your time. If you have any doubts or any clarification, that you can always contact us. We have the contact details in the description. You can go down and you can also comment. If you want to know anything more, you can let us know. We will make it a short video and we'll put it for you. Thank you so much. Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Well, the party was nice, the party was pumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started in calling. And the girls respond to the call. I have a poor one shot. Who let the dogs out?